We've heard a lot about unmanned systems as they relate to drones or self-driving cars, but for the Old Dominion University RobotX team, it's all about the boat.
I've been doing a lot of work with the Navy on unmanned systems and looking at the autonomy and how the Navy uses autonomy. And about 2.5 years ago, they asked whether we would be interested in receiving a donation of an unmanned boat with the stipulation that we would try really hard to participate in the Office of Naval Research RobotX unmanned boat competition.
The 2018 RobotX Challenge took place in Honolulu, Hawaii, where 15 teams from three continents took part in a week-long competition using a boat platform called the Wave Adaptive Modular Vessel, or WAM-V, provided to ODU by the Office of Naval Research. But there was much to do to get the vessel ready for competition.
The boat is just a chassis. There's nothing, there's no control system, there's no intelligence, there's no propulsion or anything like that. So what I have been doing in the last 2 years is working with numerous students. To this point, I think it's almost maybe 30 or 40 students doing anything from independent studies, senior design projects, master's projects, slowly building up capabilities.
Well, we're starting from scratch because this is our first year competing, unlike some of the teams which have been doing it for about 3 years. So it's been a process, but it's been fun.
The preparation has been a lot of how are we going to do this? What is the hardware we're going to use? You know, the very basic things that other teams may already have in place, we had to go through all these small iterative steps first.
Each team had to equip their vessel with hardware, software, sensors, propulsion, and control systems. The vessel must be programmed to complete several tasks autonomously, including navigation, object identification, obstacle avoidance, and data collection. All tasks must be completed without human guidance, intervention, or remote control.
For the last year or so, we have put together a team that actually at this point consists of just 6 students, which is actually a pretty small group for that type of work.
I am one of the team captains, but it's kind of widespread. So I get to do a little bit of the software. Like, I started out doing the simulations for the environment, which included simulating obstacles and wind currents and water currents. From there, I moved into a little bit of the hardware, helping with cabling and sort of learning some of that because I hadn't been exposed to that before.
Though this was the first time most of the team members had ever been to Hawaii, they knew they had to stay focused on the mission.
You have to do what they call the entrance gates, and this is just to say, is your system able to, you know, qualify or be able to operate in an autonomous way in their area? So the first thing you have to do is identify the gates and drive through them. And once you do that, then you go into a competition area where there's 4 or 5 different tasks that you then accomplish.
In the end, only 5 of the 15 teams qualified for the finals, but the ODU team did come home with $5,300 in winnings, including the $3,500 Carpe Diem Award for being willing to take on any challenge. They also received a $1,500 prize for placing second in website design and a $300 consolation prize for being a first-time competitor.
I feel very fortunate because a lot of people just go into a program, you know, they finish out, they leave, and then they go into the workforce without any real experience. And you learn a lot in your classes, but you don't really get to apply it to the real world until you get out of school. So by getting involved with opportunities like this, you're able to test those new skills and try those new methods on something real and actually see it in action. So it's been really rewarding.
For the Batten College of Engineering and Technology, this is Keith Pierce.